first, because you have not practiced it at all. Please practice it. This is a skill. This is not a knowledge one or concept I have once given you and you will forever. It will be with you forever. More you will practice, more fundas will be with you. Okay? Now my job is just to tell you how to do it. Your job is actually to do it. If you really want to learn it. Okay? And I have already told you this will come in your exams also. It will be a part of your course. Yes?
Sir, ma'am, please
do
this.
Kisko?
Sir, this question.
Go be careful. How much is the coupon rate? How much is your present value?
9,995.
What is your issue price?
95.
What is the redeemable value?
100.
What is your coupon rate or 10%. Dividend?
10%.
10%? See. 10% of 100, so 10 plus 100 minus 95 divided by how much is the number of years?
10
years of period is 10, so divide by 10, whole upon, this has to be arranged and whole upon 95 plus 100 divided by 10 into 100. See how much you are getting.
10.76.
Now, you know why this difference between 10.76 and 11%? In Excel you are getting 11%, in here you are getting 10.76. This is just the measure of time value of money. You are using future value and present value. This rate, which is more correct? This or this? This is correct. This is correct, why? Because it is considering the time value of money when you are doing it on Excel. That's why Excel results are much more accurate than that of the doing it manually. Why? Because they consider the actual time value for the future value, present value, you are taking it or not. If you are taking for 10 years and all, everything, date is calculated accordingly. Now even this is considering whether you are paying interest when? At the end or at the beginning? This formula is not considering. The type. Okay?
Even in Excel it is coming 10.84, if you need investments.
Yeah, what?
10.84, 11 is actually 10.84.
Much more nearer. 84 and 76 much more nearer. You reduce the very good. Reduce the decimal, you will get the thing. But still, there will be some difference just because of the application of the formula.
Sir,
right?
If there was any flotation charges.
So, ma'am, convinced?
So, if there are any flotation charges, that will be deducted from
100. See, if there are any flotation charges, your net proceeds will be reduced. What is your, if the flotation charges are there, then what is the actual value which you have received? 95 minus flotation charges? How much you have received? 40 years will be treated. Means flotation charges will reduce your net proceeds. What are your net proceeds? After discount you are getting 95? It will be more reduced if you have paid some flotation charges on it. You asked for the flotation charges, you got the point. The same thing is applied when we are going for the debt. Okay? Anything else? Everyone? Fine. Now the cost of equity. What is cost of equity? Cost of equity is what? What are equity shareholders are expecting and getting? Why a person will invest in equity rather than the debt and the preference shares? And let me tell you, I have been repeatedly telling you, cost of equity is the most dearest source of finance. Sabse mehenga hota hai. Why? Because the expectation of shareholders are high and they take risk when they invest in your equity shares. What type of risk it is?
Risk premium.
Risk premium is there. They should get the risk premium and there you are paying them only the fixed rate of return which is having no growth at all. Because the interest and the preference dividend always remains constant. But here what they expect? They expect
higher profits
also and the growth in the share value also. So let us see very carefully. This model was given by M. Gordon and it works when the growth rate of the company is constant and hence it is also measurable. This is given by This you have already studied it up previously. This is the actual formula which is derivation of this only. Okay? You have already written it actually. Now let us understand this quadratic model. Whenever a person invests in a share, he expects dividend and a capital appreciation. And the formula A is equal to D1 upon T0 plus G calculates the dividend expectation of the equity shareholders using the concept of dividend yield. This is what? This is the dividend yield. I mean, what is your, dekho, see, the price is P0 but the dividend is given. I think the same problem you came upon with. Okay, the price is P0 is the baseline on which you are having expectation of getting a dividend D1 in the next period. And this will give you the dividend yield and what will give you the growth and the appreciation in share prices by G. This growth is the appreciation in the share price and at what rate the prices will appreciate in the near future, which refers to the rate of growth in the share price. So this is the, I think now you have got a proper understanding of the formula, what it is and how it is. Now another important model, one of the important model is the constant growth. For example, the current market price of IDC is 643. The expected dividend per share in the next year is 16.20. What is the expected dividend? 16.20. And the growth rate is measured at 19%. What will be the cost of equity? It's very simple to calculate. Okay, A is equal to 16.20 upon 643. Because today you are paying 643 as a market development indicator. Today how much you are paying? 643. And what dividend you are receiving? 16.2 with a growth of 19% in the near future. It has become 21.50. Or in the other aspect, if the company is able to earn the rate of which, what this is the actual cost of equity. If the equity shareholders are getting what is cost of equity, it means that it will help the share to sustain in the market at the same price. Or in the other words, we can say that the company is, if the company is able to earn the rate at the rate of 21.5%, it will keep fundamentally the market price of the shares unchanged. Means the shareholders are satisfied, the market price, the share will not fluctuate. Remaining other things constant. Okay. Further, if the investor expectation increases more than 21.5, then what will happen? Then he will be willing to pay less for the same and the price will fall down. Read it once again. Further, if the investor expectation increases more than 21.5%, then he will be willing to pay less for the same. Why? Because expectation has increased and the share is not fulfilling my expectation. Why should I keep the shares? I will throw it in the market. And when everyone will think this, then there will be more supply than demand and the price will fall down. The economics, the market economics will work properly. Okay? Fine? Now this was the constant growth rate model or one stage growth rate model. Other example, let us take the same example of IDC company whose share was selling at 680. Now what is the share price? 680. The current dividend is rupees 13.62 and which is expected to grow by at the rate of 20% for next 6 years and then at constant rate of 8% forever. What will be the cost of liquidation? Now this is what it is. It is actually called the double growth method, okay, or two stage growth. One stage is your growth just because of the competition and you are new in the market and competitive strategies are there. You are having the machines and the technology and the technological or technical competences on your competitors. You may grow and gallop like anything, but the time will come and the things will become normal and you will be having a normal growth rate of 8% normal. So initially the growth rate is 20%. And then further the growth rate has become 8%. In such situation, how will you calculate the cost of equity shares? Now how it has been calculated? What is the first dividend? 13.62. You have to apply a growth factor of 20% on it. Okay. And then you will be getting all these things for the 6 years. After 6 years, it will grow by 20%. Okay, and then after 6 years, it will be the growth rate will be 8% forever. Okay, means just 8% after 6 years. Now this can also be written as if you consider this factor only, what is this? 1 upon 1 plus KE. Don't you think it is a discounting factor? 1 upon 1 plus R raised to power n. N is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So for 6 years, if you calculate the present value factor, you can do it on Excel also. This I am leaving up to you, how you do it on Excel. Okay? Then further can be said, because there are many ways of doing this. Now let us see and explore how do you do it and what are the ways you apply to complete it. Okay? So this is how the cost of equity will be calculated.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, for the 6 years we do by the present value formula. But then after 6 years, like it says 8% forever.
Yeah. How annually? You have to multiply it by this. This is the factor which you have calculated for the 6 year. Then it will be forever. Perpetual perpetuity नहीं करते हैं उसके तरह से, right? So this is the formula for doing it. It can easily be done. Okay. Now further, if you want to do it manually also, because this is the one of the other way. I will not show you this. You have to do it yourself. One thing is remaining, and that is very, very important. That will be taken in the next class of this Friday. Okay, that is calculation of beta on Excel and application of CAPM model. And all of you have to do a project, particularly on Excel, based on the current market prices for CAPM model and the calculation of cost of equity, taking the live market prices from the websites of the NSE, BSE, what are the share prices in the last, previous and past. The same will be helpful for your commodity trading also. Okay, because what will be the price of the commodity and calculation of beta, what you expect and how much return you want. So all that thing. So this exercise will be very, very important, which will be done on Friday. But why I am leaving it? Because I want to do it along with all the students. Okay, who will be present over there. So all the MBAs, all the 9 MBAs will be present over there. So we'll be doing it, I suppose, upstairs in the Vivekananda auditorium or in the Nalanda website of the. So this was all about your individual cost of capital. Now, for your final cost of capital, you know manually how to calculate it. Can you apply those manual things on Excel? Multiplying, just bringing it up, multiplying it and calculating the weighted average cost of capital, multiplying. And the sum and all one, that you will be using. What you have to do now? Yesterday we did one question. That question I need you to calculate here itself on Excel, and you have to show me the results. Do it, and you need not take help of your friend sitting around you. This is the test you can. I will check your copies.
The question we did in the class.
Yes. The question which you did manually in the class yesterday, but mind it, everything must be calculated on it.
Cost of equity.